Hey all, this is Shubhankar here from Quantsapp. Welcome back to another episode. So now in the previous videos, we had understood about what is PCR, what is India VIX, what is IVR, implied volatility rank, implied volatility percentile, and how it is going to benefit us in our trading systems. So if you haven't watched that videos, I would recommend you watching those videos as well. And there is an entire list of series when we have started options from the basic till the advanced level. So you can go ahead and watch the entire playlist. Now talking about this video, now we are going to discuss some of the bullish strategies out there which we can try to initiate in the market, and we will also try to understand when exactly we are going to initiate those type of strategies. So now before proceeding, so there is an excellent tool in our application which is named as Option Architect. Now what does Option Architect do is basically it will help us in calculating the P&L chart for our entire strategy as a whole. So now no longer we need to go ahead and manually do it on Excel to calculate our payoff chart, like on Nifty or any instrument, reaching on what level, what is going to be payoff for this strategy and all those. So the entire process would be done by the algorithm itself. All we need to do is just give inputs about our strike selection, about our strategy, and the rest the algorithm will do its job. So first we need to go ahead and select our instrument. So let's say Nifty. Then we need to select futures or options. We can select combination of both as well. Then expiry. What is the expiry in which we want to initiate our trade in? So now let's say I am selecting 29th of July 2021 and I am having, for an example, I am having a bullish view on Nifty. So for that matter, what I am doing is I am going ahead and buying a call option of 15,900 call. We can go ahead and select call or put, and we can give manual inputs about the price, whatever price we are getting it at. So we can give inputs about that, or elsewhere whatever the CMP of that option is, that would be fetched automatically. Then we need to click on add button. And our strategy would be plotted. So this is the long call which we plotted. So now whenever we are having a bullish view in Nifty, our first strategy can be we can go ahead and directly buy a call option. So let's try to first quickly understand the payoff chart below, wherein the white dotted line is showing us the today's end of the day P&L chart. The orange line on the graph is showing us the P&L as on the expiry for this particular strategy. So now let's take an example. So if Nifty be at 15,814, so the net P&L we are going to make of this strategy, which is buying a 15,900 call, today end of the day is 522 rupees. Whereas if we hold it up till the expiry day, we are going to make a loss of 2,428 rupees. So roughly around 2,400. Further, we can go ahead and just move the cursor. So we will get to see on various different levels what is going to be the P&L. So now we had looked the P&L chart as on today's end of the day. Now what if we want to see the P&L chart as on tomorrow's end of the day? So all we need to do is there is a day slider out here. We just move the day slider to one day. So the P&L which we are seeing out here, it is T plus one P&L, which is tomorrow end of the day P&L. So let's try to understand Nifty again. If the level of Nifty is 15,815 tomorrow, this strategy is going to make us a loss of 802 rupees roughly, whereas on expiry it is going to make us again a loss of 2400. So that was a simple long call. That is the first step which we do, like majority of the participants, whenever we are having a bullish view on Nifty, we simply go ahead and buy a call option. But the only problem with this thing is there is an element, or I would say an option Greek, which is named as theta. So theta is time value of money, wherein each and every passing day this option which we have bought, its value will keep on decreasing, it will keep on decaying. So a long call I would say is not recommended that much if you want to hold your strategy for, let's say, 2 or 3 days from here, especially in a weekly expiry, because ultimately even if your target comes in, you're still going to make a loss due to the theta decay, the time value of money which has been happening. So let's try to understand if we hold this strategy up till 3 days from here. So same at the level of 15,815, we are making a loss 3 days from here of 1,400. So zero becomes like our break even out here in this strategy. That in anything below zero, we are going to make a loss. Anything above zero, we are going to make a profit. So we will get to see basically on what level, what is our profit. So that was from the long call side, wherein if you are expecting that intraday move and we don't try to buy a call option and hold it for a very longer duration of time, because ultimately the theta decay is something which is going to hurt us a lot. Now, what is the alternative of it in a single leg? Simple, we can do opposite of it, which is we can sell a put option. So let's say I am selling a put option of 15,900, sell it. You can increase or decrease the quantity, and all we need to do is just add it. And then we will directly get to see the P&L chart for this particular strategy, which is I have shorted a naked put option. But the only problem with naked shorting is ultimately if Nifty does believe, if Nifty goes up till 15,000 level, okay, 15,044. So let's say if Nifty goes up till 15,000 level, we are going to make a loss of 37,200. But our max profit is capped at a point which is at a 5,000 and 5,500 level. So ultimately this strategy, it is help us in getting rid of the theta decay. Basically it will help us in getting the theta factor as well, but ultimately it is not going to match the risk appetite. Like in this type of strategy, the risk becomes unlimited. Now, as we had made a video as well on why not short a naked put. So now let's say if a very bad news comes out there in market, ultimately Nifty will have a very steady drop out there in next to no time, wherein let's say we are holding this position overnight, and let's say if a very bad news pops up, like let's say if an enemy country attacks us or any bad news. So as we all know, bad news impact the market very quicker as compared to good news. So ultimately, to gain 5,000 rupees of return, if Nifty goes up till 15,044, we are going to make a loss of 37,000. So that is a very huge kind of a risk which we are holding overnight. So now the idea is try not to short a naked put and try not to hold it overnight. I'm talking about a naked put option. So that is the second bullish strategy which we can execute. But the only benefit in this strategy is that we are getting rid of the theta decay. If Nifty moves nowhere, we are going to still make a profit, but there is a very huge risk involved in this strategy which we just discussed. So now these were the single leg options which generally participants do, and generally we try to do when our view is bullish on a particular instrument. We took an example of Nifty. Now we can go ahead and get rid of the theta decay factor in long calls as well. All we need to do is we will just sell a upper strike call option. So let's say I will also sell a 16,000 strike price call option out here. The price right now of that option is 18.7. So once I sell it, it becomes like my bull call spread. So it is called as a bull call spread, wherein you are buying and at the money, or probably one strike in the money, depending on our view. We basically are buying an at the money option and we are selling an out of the money option, so that the sold leg is also paying us off for the theta decay. Also, we are not facing a loss of an unlimited scenario, wherein, as we know, put option, the drawback was unlimited risk. Long call, the drawback was the theta decay. But this strategy will get rid of both of them and it will kind of balance it out. Although your profit would be capped and it would be not as higher as I would say and long call, but still it will also prevent us of losing the entire premium which we paid. And the other thing is the sold leg, this sold leg which is of 16,000 call, constantly it will also keep decaying, right? So even we are getting the premium out of the theta decay. So now in this strategy, zero becomes again like my break even. Anything above zero, we are going to make a profit. Anything below zero, we are going to make a loss. So the logic remains the same. White dotted line, today's end of the day P&L, and the orange line is showing us the P&L as on expiry. So my maximum loss is in this strategy is how much? It is just 2,500 as on the expiry day. So now talking about this strategy, our maximum profit is going to be at the level of our sold leg. The leg which we have sold, that becomes the level of our maximum profit. So we can have a quick look, like on 16,000 onwards, that is my level where my maximum profit is roughly around 5,000 we are making on the profit. Whereas on the downside, my losses are starting, like my max loss starts when the underlying reaches our bought leg level, which is 15,850. So whenever Nifty comes around it, our max loss is going to start as on the expiry date. Further, we can go ahead and just tweak around with the day sliders and check how exactly this strategy's P&L chart keeps on moving. So that was a bull call spread wherein we try to initiate this strategy when we expect the underlying to be slightly bullish, but when we expect the move to happen very slowly, wherein we are not expecting the move to happen very quickly. So that is the time we try to initiate a bull call spread, wherein we expect that when we want especially to hold the underlying for a decided period of time, let's say more than 2 to 4 days, and especially in weeklies, this strategy will also give us a decent amount of return if we are having a good amount of view on that particular instrument. So now, talking about when and why should be initiating this strategy. First, when we are expecting the underlying to move up, but I would say in a slowly and steady manner. Like, it is not a like kind of a very fast breakout which is going to happen, but we know that underlying is going to move in the upside direction, but the move might take some time. So when the move takes them time, we can't go ahead and buy a naked call, neither we want to go ahead and short a naked put, because that is a very heavy risk strategy. So we can go ahead and simply initiate a bull call spread when we expect the underlying to move in the upside, but in a slow and steady manner, and when we know our move is going to take some time. So now, talking about the third strategy. So fourth strategy would be a ratio call spread which one can initiate. So now the third strategy is the ratio call spread. So in bull call, what we did is basically we bought one lot of ATM and we just sold the other lot of OTM strike call options. So in this particular strategy, what we are going to do is just we need to go ahead and sell two lots of the OTM strikes which we would have sold. So I'll just click on update after increasing the quantity, and that becomes like my ratio. So it is almost, I would say, in downside, you see, if our view goes against us, so we are not facing that heavy amount of loss in this particular strategy. My maximum loss is 1700 roughly, but the only problem in this strategy is that you are going to face a loss of unlimited scenario. I would say factor of unlimited loss scenario in this strategy when the underlying moves above your strike price, when the underlying moves a lot on the upside. So in this case, if we see, this strategy will start providing us a loss at the level of 16,111. So now in this strategy, our maximum profit will again be at the point where we have sold the two calls options. So you see, 16,000 is the level where we are going to get the maximum profit. As on the expiry, we are going to make roughly around 5,500. But once the underlying starts moving above our sold legs, that is the time when we are going to start decaying in our profits, and our losses will keep on increasing. So in this strategy also, our losses are uncapped, wherein if the underlying moves on the upside a lot, so that is the time when we are going to make a huge amount of loss in this particular strategy. Now then, why we should go ahead and initiate this type of a strategy. So basically, when we know that theta is going to decay very fast, we try to go ahead and initiate this strategy because we have sold two legs out here. Alright, so we are going to get benefit out of the theta decay from 2 days. Now let's say if in the next coming days, if we are expecting Nifty to reach at level of 16,000 up till the expiry, we are going to make a 5,500 rupees of profit. But let's say even if Nifty goes against our view, we are going to make a loss of maximum 1700. Alright, so that is the reason you try to initiate a ratio when you expect the theta to decay very fast, and also you initiate a ratio when you expect that slow move in the underlying, but not a very big move on the upside. When you know that, okay, this is your target, it might come in this expiry, and you know that theta is going to decay now very, very fast. So that is the time you try to initiate a ratio. Further, we can go ahead and just cap this loss by using the other leg, using the other call option. So let's say we can go ahead and just buy the 16,100 call, one lot. Price right now is 7 rupees. I'll just click on add button, and that will become like our butterfly. So this is called as a butterfly, wherein your losses are not unlimited at any given point, and your maximum profit remains again at the level of the two legs which you have sold, wherein you see maximum loss is 2000 rupees, but on the upside, Nifty goes wherever, we are going to make a profit. So now, in this video, what we learned is a long call, naked call option buying. So it only benefits us when we don't want to hold that option for a longer duration of time. Then we learned about short puts, that short put is also again a bullish strategy, but it is having an unlimited risk and the risk is very heavy in that. So if I was a trader, I wouldn't have deployed it any day, a naked shorting of put. Then we learned about a bull call spread. Then we converted that spread by simply selling one more lot of the sold leg. So we converted into a ratio. So ratio should be ideally practiced when we expect the theta to decay very fast. And the last strategy which we learned is the butterfly. So butterfly is a slightly bullish strategy wherein your losses are also not unlimited, but your profit will be capped at a point because it is kind of an hedge strategy. Every strategy will have its pros and cons. So I would say that pretty much was it from this video. So in the next video, we will understand about the bearish kind of a strategy. So to stay tuned along with us, do hit the subscribe button, do hit the bell icon. So whenever we post something, you will receive a notification. Thank you.